what's a distracted driver? Well, it's a hoon or someone young, typically male, driving fast and taking unnecessary risks whilst behind the wheel. Well, I mean, that's the easy way to answer the question, but the truth, it's a little more complex. Driving a car involved continually collecting and interpreting thousands of pieces of data, all on a landscape that's continually changing in front of your eyes. We already know distraction accounts for around 15 to 17% of all serious crashes, but driving a car requires your concentration to be pulled in thousands of different directions. Anything that gets in the way of that diminishes your capacity to concentration. It's all a matter of focus. And if you're struggling to keep your focus, then you have everything it takes to be a destructive driver.
We need to understand risk-taking is a characteristic of young people. Risk-taking is a characteristic of being male. It's about the development, it's about exploring your environment. Now that's okay, but we then put them in a high-risk situation. We then give them a motor vehicle.
We need to move away from the hooning as believing that that's the focus and look at the fact that it's the behaviour and the way that any person can drive.
It's across the board. And because we do it all the time, we take it for granted.
Driving's one of those things that it's incredibly complex. When people start to lose that focus, things will happen that they miss.
Well, I know myself, and I think everybody can relate to being stopped at a red light. Arrow beside you goes green without thinking, you just drive forward also.
They don't see the person on the side of the road. They don't see that car that's approaching the stop sign that little bit quicker.
We've done many, many fatalities where people will be stopped at a red light, the light will go green for them, and without thinking or checking, they just drive forward because they have a green light. The other scenario we find is a car driver wishes to turn right and there's a motorbike approaching. The rider has assumed the car driver's seen him, and just as he arrives at the intersection, the car driver turns across. And when we speak to those car drivers, almost without exception, they say, I looked, but didn't see him.
Your brain's actually processing thousands of messages per second. Once you start, there is not a lot of spare capacity to do something else. The classic, I think, that's out there every day is mobile phones. The reality is, talking on a mobile phone is actually taking cognitive capacity away from the act of driving. And it's not just removing your eyes from the road, it's listening to the conversation. You're picking up how they're saying, you're picking up the emotional content of something.
They're thinking about a myriad of things in their personal life, they're just not concentrating on the things around them.
You could all think back to that time and think, I have no recollection of the last 20 kilometres that I just drove. And it only takes that split second at times for you to do the wrong thing.
The consequences from a poor choice can be devastating.
It's like throwing a rock into a pond. It just keeps going and spreading out.
Safety on Queensland's roads is everybody's business. When you're on the road, please make sure that you're completely focused on what you're doing.
We're all about providing options. We're not telling someone they can't do something, but if they're going to do it, have a good think about it. Think about where they're going, the speeds that they want to travel, think about the road conditions.
Always make sure that you're in good condition yourself in terms of fatigue, no alcohol, no drugs. Make sure that your mind and your physical well-being is in the right shape to be doing something as complex as driving. If you drive like that, you'll probably never meet us.
The safety of the community is the ultimate goal. Yes, enforcement is part of that. That's part of what we do. That's no secret at all. I'd much rather my police officers to be able to go out there and issue no infringement notices, pick up no drink drivers and have a zero road toll. It'd mean that the society's a much safer place.